pangigod ko sa akong module.
Ay na, mag-deliver para ba kung aning mga inutaw? At to lang sa imong ati patudlo, ha? Basi na kayo nung pa siya ni Ana ang eleksyon.
Dili ang kumusugot nga mapakang ang pagtuon sa atong kabataan. Bisan ubos kita sa pandemya karon, dawata kining gasa sa edukasyon, kinasingkasing ahalad, gikan ning inyong pamunuan.
Gidalit kaninyo ni Mayor Edgardo Labella, Vice Mayor Michael Lopez Rama, ang Chairman sa Committee on Education sa atong konseho, Department of Education, Cebu City Division, Cebu City Local School Board ug Home Radio 106.7, kining Cebu City Educational Laboratory on Radio o Ed Radio. Ed Radio, atong dalit aron mas musayong ang pagkat-on sa atong mga tinunan gamit ang learning modules pinaagi sa pagpaminaw sa ilang mga paboritong teacher broadcasters sa kahanginan. Tune in na sa 106.7 kay matod ni Mayor ang pagkat-on kinahanglan magpadayon.
Luka, anak, andaman ang imuhang module ug maminaw na sa Ed Radio kay magsugod na ang imuhang klase.
Yes, pa! Andam na ko! Come on, classmates! Pwede na pa mo sa ito ang klase karon? Maminaw ba ito ang tarong ni teacher, ha? Teacher! Andam na mi!
Broadcasting live from the Queen City of the South, Cebu City. This is Teacher Rex, a senior high school teacher from Cebu City National Science High School. Once again, this is your T-Rex, or Teacher Rex, roaring with knowledge. Great day, folks. Welcome to the new school year. I welcome you all to quarter one. I will be with you in the next hour to discuss quarter one, module one, week one, real or make-believe images, fact or non-fact statements. Today's radio broadcast is brought to you by the Department of Education, Cebu City Division, and the Cebu City Government. Once again, a pleasant day to all of our listeners, most especially to our grade 6 pupils. I hope you are all in the pink of health. Relax and let us take these lessons for week 1, module 1, real or make-believe images, fact or non-fact statements, one at a time. Now, I would like you to check out your ball pen, your sheets of paper, and your modules. It is also better if you have your parents or guardians with you. Well, I will guide you with today's lessons. You might have questions later on, and their presence can help you a lot. So, parents and guardians, please be with our learners in this class session on air. Thank you so much. Today, we are going to talk about the following lessons. Lesson 1, noting details of a short story. Lesson 2, real or make-believe images. And lesson 3, fact or non-fact images or statements. I have a question. Have you already answered the pretest found in the module? I know that I always ask you that, but then again, please be reminded to always answer the pretest prior to our class session on air. Very good. Now we are all set. That is right, grade 6 pupils. We are about to start the new school year with quarter 1. A resounding round of applause for all of us, and most especially to you and your parents and guardians. I would like to congratulate you all for being with us on air. I know that it's quite a struggle, yet you are still here with me. Thank you so much for that. And I'm still looking forward that you'll be with me in the succeeding quarters. Can I have an aye aye, Captain?
Aye aye, Captain!
Will you still be with me in the next quarter?
Aye aye, Captain!
I love that. Six pupils, this time I would like you to get your modules. Yes, yes, yes. We'll start on page 3, lesson 1, noting details of a short story. And here are the things that you will need to know. Note significant details from the story entitled The Stone Cutter. Number 2, identify the characters, setting, and events of the story. And number 3, tell the importance of contentment in one's life. We'll start with the activity under What's New. As you can see, we are actually to read a selection. Mm-hmm. So, would you like to read this with me? Can I have an aye aye, Captain?
Aye aye, Captain!
Again, would you like to read this with me? Very good. So you have two choices, actually. You can do number 1, you can first listen, or number 2, you can read the short story entitled The Stone Cutter with me. All right. We are about to start. The Stone Cutter, a Japanese folk tale with an unknown author. There was once a stone cutter who was dissatisfied with himself and with his position in life. One day in a Japanese market, a stone cutter passed by a wealthy merchant's house and through the open gateway saw many fine possessions and important visitors. How powerful that merchant must be, thought the stone cutter. He became very envious and wished that he would no longer have to live the life of a mere stone cutter. And the spirit of the woods heard his wish and granted what he asked for. Suddenly, he became a merchant, enjoying more luxuries and power than he had ever dreamed of, and was envied by his neighbors and friends. Soon, a high official passed by, carried in a sedan chair, accompanied by attendants, and escorted by soldiers beating gongs. Everyone, no matter how wealthy, had to bow down before the procession. How powerful that official is, he thought. I wish that I could be a high official. His wish was suddenly granted, and he became a high official, carried everywhere in his embroidered sedan chair, but feared and hated by the people all around, who had to bow down before him as he passed. One hot summer day, the official felt very uncomfortable in the embroidered sedan chair. He looked up at the sun, shone proudly in the sky, unaffected by his presence. How powerful the sun is, he thought. I wish I could be the sun. Then suddenly, he became the sun, shining fiercely down on everyone, scorching the fields, avoided by the farmers and laborers. But a huge black cloud moved between him and the earth so that his light could no longer shine on everything below. How powerful that storm cloud is, he thought. I wish I could be the cloud. Then he became the cloud, flooding the fields and villages, shouted at by everyone. But soon he found out that he was being pushed away by some great force and realized it was the wind. How powerful it is, he thought. I wish I could be the wind. Then he became the wind, blowing tiles off the roofs of houses, uprooting trees, hated and feared by all below him. But after a while, he ran up against something that would not move, no matter how forcefully he blew against it. A huge, towering stone. How powerful the stone is, he thought. I wish I could be the stone. Then, he became the stone, more powerful than anything else on earth. But as soon as he stood there, he heard the sound of a hammer pounding a chisel into the solid rock and felt himself being changed. What could be more powerful than a stone? He thought. He looked down and saw far below him the figure of a stone cutter. Well, 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 how's that? You like the story? Mm-hmm. I know, I also did. Now, this time, we are going to answer the 6 questions found right below. Yes, we are still on page 4. So, I would like to read these questions for you. And, of course, I would like you to get your ballpen and your paper. And you answer these questions. I'll be giving you about, I think 3 minutes will do. Yes, 3 minutes will do. Okay, and here are the questions. Who is the main character of the story? What was his work? What were his wishes in life? Why did he keep on changing his wish? Describe the character of the stone cutter. And lastly, number 6, if the stone cutter remained humble, what do you think will happen to him? Wonderful. Yes, I'll be giving you 4 minutes to answer this one. All right, your 4 minutes starts now. time, we shall answer the 6 questions. Yes, are you guys ready? Okay, I know. Question number 1, who is the main character of the story? What is your answer? Can you please read it for me? Well, that is correct. The main character in the story was the stone cutter. Number 2, what was his work? His work was to chisel, cut, and reform stones. How about number 3? What were his wishes in life? Well, perfect. His wishes were to live not the life of being a stone cutter. He too wished to become, number 1, a high-ranking official, number 2, a sun, number 3, a wind, and a stone. Next, why did he keep on changing his wish? He always thought that there were a lot of things that were stronger than him. And number 5, describe the character of the stone cutter. How would you do it? Can you please read your answer for me? The stone cutter was a person who was not contented of what he had in life. Yes. He was not contented at all. And number 6, if the stone cutter remained humble, what do you think will happen to him? If he remained humble, he would be the strongest person that he would be. Correct. And what is the strongest person? Correct. That is still being a stone cutter. That's it. Now, always remember that it is better to be contented in one's life. If you want to achieve something, work hard for it. Okay, now let's move on to page 5 under the activity, What I Can Do. Okay, as you can see in your model, you have here the instruction that says, write the name of the main character, supply the necessary details asked in the chart. So you are here provided with a chart, and the chart has 5 circles right here. So the first circle and the first oblong, I would have to say, it says how he looks. Next, where he lives. Next, what were his wishes? And what did he become? And at the center, you'll find this oblong that says main character. So what you're going to do is you have to label these. Okay, you're going to supply the necessary details asked in the chart. This time, I'll be giving you about 3 minutes. Yes, another 3 minutes to answer this activity. And this time, your 3 minutes starts now. 3 minutes is up. Okay, now let's start answering. Now you please tell me, what are your answers? Mm-hmm. Okay, so we'll start. Mm-hmm. The main character is the stone cutter. Okay, now how does he look? He thinks he looks weak. Mm-hmm. Where does he live? In a far village in Japan, correct. And what were his wishes? Can you please read your answer? Okay, to become the strongest man. And the last one, what did he become? Correct. At the end, he became a stone. Would you like to become a stone? I don't think so. Anyway, that's it. That ends our lesson one. Okay, this time we move on to lesson two. Yes, we are on page 6. And lesson 2's title is Real or Make Believe Images. But before that, of course, let us pause for a very short break, and I'd like you to listen to this very important message, all right? Now, I'll be back after a very short while.
Hey, Step 1 learners, welcome to the new school year. And with the current situation still, we are continuing with our educational setup. Here are a few tips to enjoy and learn amidst these trying times. Number 1. Exercise regularly and fuel your body. You need energy to sustain your physical and mental needs while enjoying RBI sessions. Number 2. Clean up and dress up. We all need to freshen up still, even though we are all learning at home. And most importantly, take time to rest. We all deserve that. And lastly, number 3. Express yourself. There is no better way to enjoy learning than being able to communicate still with your friends and family. Those are my personal tips, pupils. Be engaged and enjoy your daily dose of RBI sessions.
And I am back again. You try to follow those tips and we'll have better learning session right here on air. Thank you so much. Now, this time we move on to lesson two, entitled Real or Make Believe Images. Now, these are the things that you will have to know. You are to identify real or make believe images and differentiate real from make believe images. Okay, this time for the activity under what's in, I'd like you to answer these questions. Can we just do this orally? Okay, now question number 1. What were the wishes of the stone cutter? Mm-hmm. The wishes of the stone cutter is that he liked to become the strongest person there is. So he wished for a lot of things, a ranking official, a sun, wind, and a stone. Now, question number 2. How did he achieve his wishes? Mm-hmm. He was able to achieve those wishes through the spirit of the woods. Yes, his wishes were actually granted because of the spirit of the woods. All right, now let's move on to the next one. What can you say about the stone cutter? Yes, he was dissatisfied. He was really not contented with his life. And number 4, do you think the story is real or make-believe? Well, partly it can be real, yes, because there are really a lot of people these days who are dissatisfied, who are never contented. But then, of course, with the granting of the wishes, that makes it make-believe. Okay, because of the spirit of the woods, basically. Now, let's move on to the activity under what's new. What do you see right there? You tell me. Correct. We have 2 pictures. Okay, so what we're going to do is to observe these 2 pictures. Okay, now which of the pictures is real and which of the pictures is make-believe or not? Okay, can you please tell me the answer? How about picture number 1? Do you think that is real or make-believe? Okay, that is a real picture indeed. Yes, of course. I mean, when you go to the provinces, we'll be able to find this particular scenario, right? Have you tried doing this one? Mm-hmm. Well, I haven't. Good for you. Next, the second picture. Obviously, that is a make-believe. It's not real, right? I mean, I wasn't able to see something like this. Mm-hmm. Correct. We share the same thoughts. Now, let's move on to the next page of your module. That is on page 7. Okay, we have here an activity under what is it? Okay, and please listen or you can also read with me. Real images are pictures of things that exist, which we can see, hear, feel, taste, or touch. These images are possible to happen in real life. Okay, as you can see right there, we have those pictures. We have an old lady feeding an animal, and we have this lady right here on the right. She was holding an umbrella under the heavy rain. Now, make-believe or not real images or pictures we do not think will happen in the real life. These images are created through the imagination of the people. These are impossible to happen, hence, these do not exist. All right, as you can see right here, a school of fish. Yes, literally, a school. Mm-hmm. And we also have right there a picture on the right. It looks like a superhero. Mm-hmm. Real versus make-believe images. As you go along with reading, you always come across images or pictures in the different stories you read or images in your favorite magazine. However, the question is, which picture shows real or just a make-believe? How can we say it is real or how can we say just make-believe? Mm-hmm. Yes, yes, yes. Real images are images that are possible to happen, while make-believe images are images made from the imagination of an artist. It is impossible to happen in real life. Now, to make myself clear, was I clear with the explanation? Okay, wonderful. But anyway, you know, you can always go back to the text. Yes, you can always go back to the discussion. Indeed, this is about real images or make-believe images. Now we go into the next activity under what I can do. I'm very much excited about this activity. You are to look at each picture below. You are to put a check if it's real and an X if it is make-believe. So how many pictures we have here? There are 6 pictures. I'd like you now this time to get your ball pen and your paper and have them numbered with 1 through 6. And you have to put a check mark right after the number. Either, again, a check mark if it's real or an X if it's a make-believe picture or image. Are you ready? Okay. Aye, aye, Captain. Again, are you ready?
Aye, aye, Captain.
Very good. Now, your 3 minutes. 3 minutes. Do you think that will be enough or more than enough? I guess 2 minutes will be enough. All right. So 2 minutes will be given to you for this activity. Your 2 minutes starts now. Thank you. Your 2 minutes is up, grade 6 pupils. Now this time we are going to go back to your module. All right, take a look at the pictures again. Mm-hmm. And you tell me, should there be a check mark if it's real, or should there be an X mark if it's make-believe? Okay, let's start with number one. Mm-hmm. Is that a check or an X? Okay, good. It is an X indeed, because this is an image of a heroine. Yes. A Filipino heroine, that is Darna. Okay, make believe that is. How about number two? That is a check mark. Very good. So basically, this is a picture of Heidelin Diaz, our very first gold medalist in the Olympics. Yes. Number three, is that a check or an X? Yes, that is an X, basically. Well, we could not just do that. I mean, jump off a cliff and fly. Number four. Yes, that is a check, of course. That is a picture of an eagle. Number five. Very well, that is also a check mark, of course. That's a picture of a baby, a newborn baby, I'd have to say. And number six, a goose that lays golden eggs. That is an X, obviously. How I wish we can have one in real life. Anyway, let's move on to the activity under What's More. We are to read the following sentences and identify whether it is real or make-believe. So I'll be giving you about 3 minutes for this one. Yes, 3 minutes for this activity. So you still have your ball pen and your paper with you. You label it with this one. Okay. We're done with what I can do. So you label it with what's more. And you have this numbered by 1, 2, 5. Okay, you know what to do. You're going to identify whether it's real or make-believe. So you write real or make-believe. Okay, your 3 minutes starts now. Your 3 minutes is up. Yes, yes, yes. Your 3 minutes is up. This time, we're going to check your answers. Are you guys ready? Okay, number one. The spirit of the woods heard his wish and granted what he asked for. Is that real or make-believe? That is make-believe, of course, right? Number two. Can you please read it for me? Okay, what is that? That's real. Number three. Then he became the cloud, flooding the fields and villages, shouted at by everyone. Yes, obviously, that's make-believe. Number 4, can you please read it for me? Okay, that is real. And number 5, he became the stone more powerful than anything else on earth. Obviously, that's a make-believe, right? Okay, that's it, grade 6 learners. We are done with lesson 2. Now we are moving on to lesson 3. Fact and non-fact images or statements. And these are the things that you need to know. Differentiate fact from non-fact statements and try the examples of fact and non-fact statements at the same time. Okay, now we are met with the very first activity. What's in? You are to write real or make-believe on the blank. There are interesting pictures right there. There are 5 pictures. I'd like you to take a look closely at these pictures and write the words real or make-believe after every number. So again, you label your paper with what's in, or first lesson 3, then what's in, then write the numbers 1 to 5, and you write whether real or make-believe. Okay, now I'll be giving you about a couple of minutes for this one. So your 2 minutes starts now. Your 2 minutes is up, grade 60 plus. Now let's check your answers. Number 1, okay, is that real or make-believe? Yes, that's a make-believe picture, correct. Number 2, we all miss that, right? Face-to-face classes, that's real. Number 3, obviously that's make-believe. Who are these characters? Do you know them? Correct, these are Jasmine and Aladdin. Prince Jasmine and Aladdin. And number 4. Yes, the Filipino character. Captain Barbel. That's make-believe. And number 5. We also miss this kind of activity. That's real. Alright, now moving on to what's new. What page are we now? Correct. We are now on page 10. Now, have you read fake news? Where did you read these? How did you know that it was fake news? How do you say that the news you are reading tells about facts? Why? Read the sentences below and try to identify which is fact and non-fact. Okay, now first statement. Once I received the COVID-19 vaccine, I no longer need to wear a mask. Next, if I receive the COVID-19 vaccine, I am at a greater risk to become sick from another illness. Next, masking, hand washing, and physical distancing remain necessary in public until a sufficient number of people are immune. Fully vaccinated people can meet with other fully vaccinated people without wearing masks. There's no evidence to suggest that getting the vaccine heightens your risk to become sick from another infection such as the flu. I know that you were able to identify which of those statements are facts and which of those statements are non-facts as well. The very first statement says, once I receive the COVID-19 vaccine, I no longer need to wear a mask. We still need to wear masks. Yes, that is correct. That is still to protect ourselves and others because not all of us are already vaccinated. If I receive the COVID-19 vaccine, I am at a greater risk to become sick from other illnesses. This is not true. This is not fact. Yes, you are being protected. Correct. If you have the COVID-19 vaccine. Well, you still have risk, of course, of acquiring other illnesses, but it's not greater risk as compared to really not having, or I mean, to having COVID-19 vaccine. Okay, a third statement, masking, hand washing, physical distancing remain necessary. Yes, that is correct. That's fact. And there's no evidence to suggest that getting the vaccine heightens your risk to become sick from another infection such as the flu. Yes, again, as I've said, we can still be infected. You know, we still have the risk of getting all those other illnesses. But then again, we are protected from severe COVID. Okay, or again, being hospitalized, basically. All right. Fact is a statement that is true. Yes, fact statements are statements in true occurrence. It can be tested and verified and arguably true to everybody. Fact can be based on experiences, experiments, and laws that govern the whole universe. For example, the sun is a star. Nobody could question that, right? Seeds grow when planted. We see that. Rodrigo R. Duterte is the president of the Philippines. That is a fact, currently. Non-fact statement is something that is not a fact. Something that is presented as a fact, but actually untrue. It is considered wrong since there is no basis. For example, motorbikes can move even without gasoline. This one's funny. Next, coronavirus is not a communicable disease. And computer is not useful during pandemic. Fact is a true statement with basis, while non-fact is an untrue statement that can be argued falsely. We go back to non-fact. Motorbikes can move even without gasoline. This is quite funny these days, you know. But then maybe at some point there will be a motorbike that can be invented that can actually move or go around without even a gasoline. Who knows what's going to happen in the future. But currently, that's considered to be non-fact. Next, coronavirus is not a communicable disease. I mean, hello? Look around you. I mean, look around all of us. Look what's happening. Don't you think it's not communicable? Millions and millions of people around the world have had this one. And many have perished at the same time. Next, computer is not useful during the pandemic. Of course, this is very, very useful. It has become more useful, basically. Everything's been online these days. Now, let's move on to the activity under what I can do. This is basically the last activity for this lesson. Okay, we are now on page 11. There are 10 items right here. You are to identify each statement, whether it's a fact or non-fact. You write your answer on the blank. So I'll be giving you about 4 minutes for this one. Yes, 4 minutes. You just have to write the answer right after the number. So you get your ballpen now and your paper. And again, we are on lesson number 3 and you label it with what I can do. Write the answers 1 to 10. Your 4 minutes starts now. up, let us now try to go over your answers. Okay. Now, what I can do, identify each statement, whether it is a fact or non-fact. Write your answer on the blank. Mm-hmm. We have 10 statements right here. Can you please read statement number one for me? In 3, 2, and 1. Okay. What do you think that is? Fact or non-fact? Correct. That is a fact. We all need food to survive. Yes, that's the basic need, I would have to say. How about number two? Can you please read it for me? Mm-hmm. In 3, 2, and 1. Mm. Okay. Now, do you believe so? Junk foods are healthier than fruits. Mm-hmm. Is that a fact or non-fact? All right. Obviously, that is a non-fact. Yes, junk foods are never healthier than fruits. We are all encouraged to eat more fruits and vegetables, most especially people your age, the very young ones, and even people my age as well, the adults. Number three, our body is composed of 70% water. Mm-hmm. Is that fact or non-fact? Well, according to science, this is a fact. Yes. Surprisingly, our body is composed of 70% water, that is. Number four, can you please read the statement for us? Mm-hmm. Oh, there are fruits that do not have seeds. Is it fact or non-fact? Correct. That is a fact. Yes, according to research as well. And based on experience, right? I mean, we have eaten fruits that don't actually have seeds. Number five, eating vegetables makes your skin glow. Mm-hmm. Is it true? Does it make your skin glow? Correct. Number five is a fact, of course. So you have to eat more fruits and vegetables in order for you to have glowing skin, healthy glowing skin, that is. And number six, can you please read the statement for us? Mm-hmm. Is it fact or non-fact? Well, obviously, it's a non-fact, right? I mean, exercising contributes greatly to us becoming fit and healthy. Have you exercised before, or have you been exercising? Mm-hmm. Well, I've done so, and it did actually help me so much. Number seven, chocolates help boost your brain to think. Is that fact or non-fact? All right, this will be based on science. Yes, it is basically a fact. Chocolates help boost our brains to think. But we should not overeat chocolates. Yes, that's a lot of sugar, I have to say. Number eight, beans are a good source of protein. Mm-hmm. That is correct. I think we have known this one, you know, in your lower grades. I believe you were able to discuss the Go, Grow, and Glow foods, right? And this topic has been discussed by your teacher, I have to say. Mm-hmm. So that is basically a fact. And number 10, candies make your teeth stronger. Again, candies make your teeth stronger. Is that fact or non-fact? Obviously, that is non-fact. You can ask your dentist. All right, so that's it. Now let's review. Number one is a fact. Number two is non-fact. Number three is fact. Number four is a fact. Number three is fact. Number six is non-fact. Number seven is fact. Number eight is also fact. Number nine is also a fact. And number 10 is non-fact. Well, that is it. That ends all of our three lessons for lesson number 1, 2, and 3. I would have to say these three lessons basically of module 1, week 1, quarter 1. Again, welcome to the first quarter, everyone. So that is it. Thank you so much. I know that you've actually learned so much from all these three lessons. Well, this time you are all ready to answer the post that's found on page 11 and 12. Enjoy answering. I hope you will find time to answer the post that so that you can really check if we had a worthwhile time during our discussion on air. Perfect. Now you are ready to embark into quarter 1, module 2, week 2. See you all. Thank you so much. Please do know you are all amazing. Now, this has been your T-Rex or Teacher Rex, roaring with knowledge. I hope that you have learned something in today's discussion. Always remember the words of Margaret Fuller. Today, a reader. Tomorrow, a leader. Keep on, Cebuano learners. And I would like to end this session with this reminder from me, Teacher Rex, your T-Rex. Keep on believing, keep on shining, be empowered, and be the change. Have a great day, everyone. Bye-bye.
Luca, anak, kamusta? Humanabayan niyo ang klase?
Oo pa! Magdaghana po niyo mga bago nakatunan karon. Di ba, classmates?
Wow! Very good!
Classmates! Magkuyog pi agihapon ta sa sunod na tong klase, ha? See you!
Mao kadto ang atong kinasingkasing nahalad alang sa atong mga tinun-an aron ang pagkat-on magpadayon bisan pa man sa mga kabag-uhan nga resulta sa pandemya. Dalit kaninyo sa Cebu City Government Local School Board, Cebu City Council, Department of Education, Cebu City Division ug sa Home Radio 106.7. Atangi ang sunod nga klase sa kahanginan. Hangtod sa sunod higayon, ayaw si Piata sa pagpaminaw sa Ed Radio tungod kay ang pagkat-on kinahanglan magpadayon.